Hi everyone, Miranda here from Miranda's Ornaments, and today we are going to make a 5-point Christmas star quilted ornament. And for this ornament you will need 2 6-centimeter balls, which is about 2 3/8 of an inch. So take a ball somewhere that size. You're going to need ribbon. This is 4-centimeter wide ribbon. That's about 1.5 inch. If you're using wider ribbon like this, you can cut it in two. You're going to need some hobby glue, a gold pin in this case, depends on the color you're using, 80mm pins, a trick marker or a fine liner in a color of your choice, a flexible measuring tape, scissors, a thimble, and I think that about covers it. Now, if your ribbon is wired like this, you are going to have to take the wire out first. The pieces you're going to use, you have to cut them the width of the ribbon, which is about 4 centimeters, 1.5 inch, and by 7 centimeters long, which is about 2 3/4 of an inch. Before we start, you're going to mark your ball first, and this time the ball, the equator, needs to be divided into 5 equal parts. Now, I put the measuring tape around my ball and it measures 18.9 centimeters. Now, I made a quick calculation, old school, and divided in 5, it means each part is going to be 3.78 centimeters. So, if this is not convenient for you, you can always take the paper strip and divide it in 5 equal parts, just as I described in my basic quilted ornament tutorial. When I mark the equator, I start at, I put a stripe, a marker. Just opposed to the equator. I'm sorry, I can't find the right word for it right now. And when I start to mark, I start somewhere around 5 or 10 centimeters, just to be able to hold the flexible measuring tape in the same place. Now, we have to divide it in parts of 3.78, so that's about 3 3/4 of a centimeter. So we're going to mark that here. And then I'm going to move the centimeter around. Well, let's take 5 and just add 3 3/4 centimeters, like that. Put it at 5 again, and let's see where the equator went. Right there. So I'm going to mark it here. And over there. And let's see if we did this correctly. Yay! So now it's divided into 5 equal parts. Now you're going to put a dot here in the middle. And on the other side it is marked as well. going to put a dot over there. Now, if you're not comfortable with this, you can always use the trick marker first. Lines of the trick marker will disappear through light or a little bit of water. When you made mistakes, it's the better option to use. Now we're going to lay the measuring tape over the marker and the dots. And we're just going to make a line from top to bottom. And you're going to draw another line from top to bottom. And you do the same with the other three lines. Now that you've marked your entire ball, we're going to use the ribbon. Now, I always fold it in half to be able to see the middle. And you're going to put a pin just below the edge of the ribbon, like that. Not too high up. You can put it a little lower with this ribbon because it is not translucent. And you're going to put it just below the red dot on the helping line. And make sure you're going to put the pin towards you when pinning it in, like so. This is to prevent it from peeking out later. You're going to put in the pin. You can press it with the thimble. You're going to put it on the helping line. You're going to fold this corner down and make sure the pin disappears underneath. And just fold it over the helping line a little bit to the right. Now you're going to do the other side. Make sure the pin on top disappears underneath. Just fold it a little bit over the left edge. And a little bit to the left. So it's on this side of the helping line. Now you put in the pin and make sure it goes through both of the layers. Press it down. And now you're going to smooth out one corner. Might as well do this one. You can choose to do it the other way. Because we don't have an even number, we're just going to round them and put the last corner under this one. Now for the second one. Going to fold it to determine the middle. It's not necessary, but I like to have everything straight. Put in a pin just like that. Now go on the right side, just below the red dot. Put in your pin. Align it with your helping line here. Hold it. And now press your pin in place just beside the first one, like so. And folding down the corner again. The left corner and the right. Put in a pin, and this time you're going to smooth out both corners. Don't pull on them, because if you pull on them, this is what will happen. You don't want that. Just smooth them out really soft. They just need to lay flat on the surface of the ball. And smooth this one out. Put in a pin. And there you have your second one. Now you're going to do the same with the third, the fourth, and the fifth. And I'll come back here. Now you've come to the last part of the first layer. this ribbon is horrible, it frays all over the place. So you're going to put in the last one. Remember to put the pin towards you when sticking it in. And press it in place. Just like that. Fold the corners down. Put in a pin. Don't put it too low because of the fraying of the ribbon, it might get loose again. And let's see. We're going to smooth out the left corner first. And this time we're going to put this one up because this is the left corner, and we're going to smooth this one out first. And now it's this one's turn to smooth out. I'd like to reverse it. Let me just cut these off. You can fray the ends up front if you like to, with a lighter or just a candle lined. So this is your first layer, and you can see it all goes in one direction. Now for the second layer, we're going to use this ribbon. We're going to fold it again and put the pin just below the edge, like so. And we're going to be pinning this at 1.5 centimeters, and that's about 5/8 of an inch. So I'm putting the 5 centimeter in the middle. Let me see, yes. And we're going to put the pin on the right half of the ribbon. And I hope you can see it, because the ribbon is so shiny. And remember, with every new patch, you pin it towards you. And 1.5 centimeter from the middle. And you're going to do the same as you did with the first layer. And now make sure those edges lie on top of each other. I think that's most beautiful. Make sure you pin them through both. And we decided to leave the left edges up, but you can always decide to work the other way around. So you leave this one up and you smooth this one down, so you will get it at a reverse. So I'm going to put the left one down first and work this way. And for the last one, I'm holding the centimeter at a centimeter. It's a centimeter in Dutch. I mean the measuring tape. I'm holding it in the middle at 5. So I have a grab over here to hold it. Now on the right half, 1.5 centimeters from the middle, put the pin towards you. Line it with your helping line. And fold it down. This is a really thick ribbon. It's not always handy to use, but I love it. Now you have these two left, and we decided when we were doing this layer, we would leave the right corner up. So we're going to smooth this out and put a pin in the left corner first. And then this one. Like that. Now there you have your first layer. And I've made these before in red and silver. I don't have them anymore. And with that one, there was some foam peeking through over here. So I went ahead and put in extra parts over here. But now I see with this one, it isn't necessary. So if you like it this way, and at yours there isn't any foam peeking through in this corner, you can choose to leave it like this and go ahead and do the other side. But if you want to see a multiple of a 5-point with some extras, I'm going to show you that now. I can't remember if I did mention how many pieces of ribbon you need. For this one, you're going to need 10 for both sides. And you're going to need a strip of ribbon to work around the ball at the end for the finish. And from this ribbon, if you are going to leave it like this, you're also going to need 10 pieces. If you're going to go on with what I am about to show you next, Bob, you're going to need 20 parts. Now, I decided I want to do it 3 centimeters from the middle. So I'm going to lay my measuring tape and I'm going to pin it in at 8 centimeters because there's 5 at the middle. Just pin it in a little and then you're going to see if it's in nice in the middle of the corner. It is. So you are just going to use these two alping lines to align it straight. And just fold it down. And just keep the middle between these two lines. If you are not comfortable with that, you can always add extra markers up front. Now we have to determine if we want to... You know what? I guess I'm not liking this. I'm going to put it higher up. I decided to put it up at 2.5 centimeters from the middle, which is about 1 inch. And I decided to leave the left corner up this time. So on to the next. Oops. And 2.5 centimeters. Check if it's in the middle. It is. And align it with the help of these two lines. And make sure this is lying smooth either. Don't pull it too hard because with ribbon your pin might be going through it. Now, smooth out the corners. and now it already looks like this. Ain't that pretty? Now you're going to do the other three. Now, there you have it. Your first half is finished. And now you're going to do exactly the same on the opposite side. And make sure when you had, with the first layer, you had the, let me see, the left corner up. So on the other side, with the first layer, you're going to leave the left corner up also. Now one more time. Just below. And you're going to stick it in just below the red dot on the helping line. The pin facing towards you. And, ooh, and the sun is interfering, so I hope the video stays okay. Your new helping line is this one on the other side. Make sure you stick the pin through both. Whoops. Just. All right. It grabbed some binding. And we said we're going to leave the left corner up. Yes. So we're going to smooth out the right one. So now you're going to work around until the last part and then I'll get back. For the second layer, we decided to leave the right corner up. You put it in on the right half of your former triangle at 1.5 centimeters from the middle. And you use the triangles on the opposite side to use as a helping line. Now we decide to left right to leave the right corner up, so we're going to smooth out the left one. And if you are only using one layer, this is or two layers, this is important. If you, however, are using that layer, well, you can't show, it doesn't show that much, just a little. So it doesn't matter that much if what direction you choose. Just as long as it's all in the same direction. Now, for the third and last layer, you did put it in, you do put it in from 2.5 centimeters, about 1 inch from the center. And as you are doing this, you will notice that your piece will get too far over the equator. Now, we don't want it. Want that because we can't finish the ornament the right way then. So you're going to fold it and then you're going to try to determine the middle. Now I think the middle is about here. Let me see. Just between this and this point. And with this layer, we decided to leave the left corner up again. So we're going to smooth out the right one. And the right one, you will always also have to determine where the middle is. So we're going to put the pin higher up. About there. Now on to the next patch. 2.5 centimeters. About there. Always remember to put the pin towards you. Yes, this is in the middle of the corner. And use this seam to guide you. Use it as a helping line. And again, put up your pin a bit higher. Like so. And smooth out both corners. And make sure you put the pins in the middle of your ball. Yes. And also the other side. And if this goes rough because you're using a thick ribbon like I am right now, you can always use the thimble to press it down. Now for the last part, going to smooth out the corner, put a pin in the middle of the ball, and this is going really hard, so, and we want this one to be underneath. This one on top. And now we have a lot of excess fabric, so we're going to cut it off. Now start here and be very careful you don't slide your scissors under a part you don't want to be cut off. So this is a really thick ribbon, so we're going to cut it beneath the pins. We're just going round the ball. And just lift it up from time to time to see if you are still cutting it right. Because you don't want to accidentally put your scissors behind a part that doesn't need to be cut. Just take your time doing this. Check from time to time. Oh, this is a nasty one. When you're finished, your ball will look something like this on the side. It's time for the finish. I decided to use the gold ribbon because it is much more flexible than the other ribbon to finish the ball. And to do that, you're going to wrap it around your ball. Like so. Overlap a little and cut it. Now you're going to fold your ribbon to the middle. Whoops. And fold the other half also back to the middle. Now, and this ribbon is fraying like crazy, so I'm going to try to melt it a little with a lighter. See if that's going to work. Really careful, because I know the metallic parts can easily catch fire. Whoops. So, you're going to determine what the top of your ball is going to be. You can put it on the top of the star or with the point down. I decide I want a point up. So, I'm going to, let me zoom in first. I'm going to put it just right a little bit over the edge. Let's see, let's move it a little so it's in the middle. And just pin it down, not too close to the edge. And the other core. And now you're just going to wrap it around your ball. Pull a little on it, but not too hard. And you're supposed to cover all the pins that are underneath the ribbon. And fold the ribbon with you as along you go, as long as you go. And just make sure it stays in the middle. And just hold it firmly. Now we reach the end with the same fraying problem. So let's see if we can tackle this one too. Oops. And I hope to melt it together a little. Well, at least it doesn't fray anymore. You finish your bauble. And when you're at the end, you can fold it in like so. Hold it and put in a pin over here. And over here. Two pins didn't want to let go of each other. Press them down, and here you have your first bauble. Now you can adjust the ribbon a little if you just check to see if it all is. And now for the bow, if you want one. When you want to make a bow, you're going to need for each bow, I'm using two, a piece of 62 centimeters. And when you are using inches, it's most handy to use a piece of, let me see, 25 inches for the loops. And 1 inch extra for the end part. So in total 26 inches from which you are will be making loops from 2½ inch each, and for the end parts, 1/2 inch each. And for the tutorial, for the bow, you can watch the bow for the quilted ornament tutorial. And I'm going to show some first preps you need to make. You are also going to need a hanging part of 15 centimeters, and this is about 6 inch. I'm going to fray the ends first. And now I'm going to use this one first. Well, I have my my measuring tape on top, but that's all right. I'm going to use my trick marker, and I'm going to mark a centimeter from the end. I'm going to move it over, and then I'm going to make parts of 6 centimeter each. So 6, and then 12, and then 18, and so on until the end of the ribbon. These are the measurements for this ball's ribbon, and for the tutorial you can watch the bow for the quilted ornament. I guess I forgot to mention that the decoration pin I am using, and it already I tried to put it in, it already bended, so, but it didn't snap, so I'm going to use it anyway. That pin is about 3½ centimeters, and your pin shouldn't be any longer than the diameter of your ball, of course. So 1¼ to 1¾ inches would be fine. Now, when you have your bows finished, I'm always going to put some glue on the pin after having inserted it first, because the layer is so thick, it's best if you do that first to make sure it doesn't snap with all the glue on it. Now, this is going to be really tricky. Now, I just got it away from camera to be able to get a firm hold on it. It can be tricky to pushing the pin, but I managed. So here is the finished ornament. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below this video. And if you have any other questions, you can always email me at info@mirandasornaments.com. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.